This episode is sponsored by Fabulous, an app that helps you form healthy habits that stick. Click the link in the description to get 25% off of a Fabulous premium subscription. Space is pretty inhospitable, but humans have managed to maintain a permanent presence up there, a few hundred kilometers above the threshold we call the edge of space, since November 2000. But we've also carried up some unwanted stowaways, which can threaten the well-being of both the astronauts and the station that separates them from the vacuum of space. Microbes, bacteria, fungi, and the like. Thankfully, scientists have figured out a few ways to keep things clean. Now, you may have heard that the human body is full of non-human cells. Collectively, these microscopic critters make up your microbiota, and they are basically in every corner of the human body. So astronauts provide a steady supply of microorganisms to the space-based environments they inhabit, no matter how clean they were before they got there. Equipment and supplies are cleaned inside special rooms to remove any unwanted travelers, but it's never a 100% success rate. So with each round of deliveries, be they new people or new experiments, microbial invaders try to settle into their new home. Life trying to find a way. Over the years, scientists have closely studied the kinds of invisible life forms living on the International Space Station. Back in 2019, one team published a catalog of both bacterial and fungal species, in part to figure out where they were actually coming from. Are humans the primary source, or insufficiently cleaned supplies? Well, it turned out to be the former. Members of the astronauts' microbiota were migrating to various parts of the station, from the toilets to the panel next to that pretty cupola window they take pictures from. The most prominent types of bacteria were Staphylococcus and Enterobacteria, which are commonly found on your skin and up your nose, and in your gut, respectively. Altogether, the exact combination of microbes living on all of the surfaces inside the ISS is unique. Like, it's different from the ones in the air filters or in the prototype Martian habitation units humans have been testing living inside down here on Earth. Scientists have even discovered new species up there, though that isn't necessarily a huge revelation, because they also find new species here on Earth all the time, and these new ones aren't that different from the earthly ones. But there is one way they are adapting. Some species are evolving to tolerate living on certain surfaces that would ordinarily kill them. So scientists are worried about the threats these microbes could have to both astronauts and the International Space Station itself. The human immune system doesn't work the same way in space as it does on Earth, and many kinds of medical care aren't readily available when you are hurtling around the Earth hundreds of kilometers away at speeds of 8 kilometers a second. The human microbiota naturally includes bad microbes as well as good ones, but normally our bodies can handle them. However, pathogens could take advantage of a decreased immune response in space. Also, studies back here on Earth have demonstrated that patients admitted to the ICU are at higher risk of getting an infection if the previous person in their bed had one. So the enclosed space of the ISS could mean a later crew could get infected by a previous one. There's also the threat of how life in outer space affects antibiotic resistance, but the results on this appear mixed. And certain microbes can also be a problem for the ISS's equipment, too. Back in 1998, cosmonauts on the Mir space station discovered microbes were breaking down the rubber around the station's windows, as well as dissolving electrical cables by excreting some kind of acid. And some of the species aboard the ISS have been shown to corrode metals down here on Earth, but how much they're doing that up in space is still unknown. There's also the possibility that in sufficient quantities, they could actually cause mechanical blockages and make equipment overheat. So astronauts need a way to get rid of all of these unwanted microbes, but they can't go too hard on sanitizing because their microbiota is so crucial to their health. It turns out that the cleaning methods are pretty similar to what you or I have to do down here on the ground, except for the whole floating debris and the completely closed air system thing. Everything they touch gets hit with disinfectant wipes, handrails, computers, and so forth. The air filters have to get changed regularly so colonies don't grow there either. They also vacuum a bunch. That's also to prevent dust from floating around and getting stuck where it is not supposed to be, because in microgravity, it doesn't get collected in the carpet. Down here on Earth, scientists are looking for new technology to make the ISS less habitable to microbes, too. Metals like silver and copper are already known for their antibacterial properties, so making things like handles out of certain alloys could kill bugs before they even get a fighting chance. But not everything on the space station could be metallic, so they're testing polymers, too. Ultimately, studying how these microbe colonies act differently from those on Earth will help us prepare for longer missions to the Moon, to Mars, and beyond. Also, studying how much these little bugs can tolerate the extreme conditions of space helps future missions that will require sanitizing the spacecraft to protect the distant world from being unintentionally inhabited by Earthlings like our little bugs. preventing the spread of germs to astronauts and to other corners of space. So if you want to add deep clean the apartment to your habit list to keep germs at bay, you should check out today's sponsor, Fabulous. They are a habit and self-care forming app that's fully customizable to support your personal goals, like keeping a relatively germ-free International Space Station or crafting a distraction-free workspace. With Fabulous Premium Subscription, you'll also unlock coach sessions and journeys to inspire a shift in mindset, like incorporating small, simple habits in your evening routine. If you want to check them out, the first 100 people who click on the link will get 25% off a premium Fabulous subscription, which also helps us. So thanks.